My name is Cheryl Rosenfeld, and I'm an associate professor of biomedical sciences and a Bond Life Sciences Center investigator at the University of Missouri. My laboratory is involved in studies to evaluate the effects of long-term, low-level exposures to bisphenol A, a chemical that we believe constitutes a potential serious public health concern to animals and humans. Bisphenol A, or otherwise termed BPA, is a member of a large family of chemicals called endocrine disruptors or endocrine disrupting compounds. These man-made substances are contained in thousands of products and have become pervasive in the environment. For the past decade, substances like BPA were thought to disrupt our genes by mutating strands of DNA. We now know that there are factors that can affect the expression of DNA without having to change its actual structure. It's like accidentally overlaying your thumb when taking a photo of your family. Your family did not actually disappear, but the camera's ability to detect and document your family's presence was inhibited. Just as with the photo analogy, anything that obscures part of the DNA and prevents it from being transcribed is considered epigenetic change. My laboratory team and others here at MU are working to determine whether BPA may be contributing to potentially harmful epigenetic changes. DNA is made up of chemicals called nucleotides. One of these nucleotides can be chemically modified by adding a methyl group onto it, a process called methylation. Here's how it works. Non-methylated DNA can be activated by transcription factors, compounds that bind to the promoter or light switch region of the DNA and activate it. Methylated DNA, however, blocks transcription factors from reaching the promoter site. Should the methyl groups be removed, these factors can once again attach to the DNA and activate it. In higher organisms, methylation plays a critical role in keeping the genetic expression process stable and orderly. However, BPA might induce inappropriate DNA methylation or remove old methyl groups. Another type of epigenetic change involves proteins that bind to DNA, or histone proteins. The binding of histone proteins to DNA blocks the ability of transcription factors from finding and activating DNA. Yet, if these proteins are pulled off the DNA, the transcription factors can once again bind and turn it on. However, BPA might also alter histone protein binding to DNA. Epigenetic change also involves altering the chromatin structure that DNA resides on. Chromatin is a combination of DNA and the proteins associated with it. Under the microscope, chromatin has a fiber appearance. If the chromatin is tightly coiled or like tangled up yarn, transcription or casting onto the DNA is quite difficult. However, if the chromatin becomes untangled, transcription can proceed. By altering DNA methylation and histone protein binding to DNA, BPA might then induce changes in the chromatin state. Epigenetic mechanisms also involve a substance called microRNA. Most RNA in the body is destined to be translated or decoded into a protein. However, some small or microRNA acts as a decoy. They bind to RNA that otherwise would have been translated into a protein. Once an RNA is bound to a microRNA, their ultimate fate is destruction. BPA may also affect this process and lead to inappropriate production of these microRNAs. In general, industry officials making plastics that contain BPA have not tested their products as potential agents of epigenetic changes. My lab and many others here at MU and around the world are working to do just that. Thus, we are providing a scientific foundation for what we hope will be a thorough reevaluation of BPA's effects on human health.